So for harnessing small dogs, you gotta make sure you have two different kind of leads because they'll help you out. You're gonna start off by making sure that this is good to their head and that this is around your wrist. When you get the size of the head, you're gonna open the door cautiously. You're gonna have like this. I like to swoop my hand under and catch them, that way they don't jump. And like push them towards the back. You're gonna slip the head over. You go like this. And then you're gonna take the green and you're gonna go over the left arm. And then you're gonna take the red, which is the opposite color, and you're gonna go over the right. And then you're gonna make sure to pull up, that way they can't wiggle out. And then you're gonna wrap tight by the base. And then when you get right here, you're gonna make sure and you hold them football style.
Don't forget to demonstrate the X.
And then you'll know you have it right when you have the X on their chest.
Okay.
Can you see that? Alright, and then when you get back in from your walk, your kennel door should already be open. So all you have to do is you walk in, you place them down, you undo your hands, and you just slide the leaves over their head and down their body. Make sure you get their arms out. And then once all of that out, you remove those and you push them back and make sure they don't jump out. You close them. And then I like to pull on it just to make sure it's closed, because it has happened before that it wasn't. And so yeah, small dog harnessing.
Today we're gonna show you how to harness a fractious dog. First, you get your two leashes, make sure they're around your wrist, and for it to be easier, you should get two different color leashes. Make the hole big enough to fit around the dog's head depending on their size. And then you approach the cage out of the cage. Make sure someone's helping you hold them so they don't fall out. You put the leashes around their head. Put one leash on one arm, leg, and then the other on the other leg, making sure it makes an X on the top and on the bottom, like that. And then you just carry them like this if they're small and start your walking.
So in summary, for harnessing small dogs, these are your do's and don'ts. You would want to get two different color leads because it helps with not getting confused and not wasting time. So if you were to get same color leads, you would get extra confused and you're just gonna start wasting time and putting harnessing them to get out. When you're doing husbandry, everything has to be done quickly in order not to waste time. You would also want to ask for help, because imagine if you have a fractious small dog. I mean, imagine like that little dog trying to get out of the cage. You're gonna get points off for letting a dog out and probably get in trouble for that. So it's better to have somebody to help you out. It also goes back to being cautious with the dogs, because if they were to fall out of the cage, I mean, they could get hurt and things like that. So always watch out for them, make sure they don't fall out of the cage, ask for help. You would want to make an X when you put on the leads, because it helps you have more control of the dog when you're taking them out, and also it's required to do an X. If you don't make an X and you just put the leads around the neck, it gives, like the chances of the dog getting out is higher than the chances of them not getting out when it's an X. So yeah. And then you would want to wrap the leads around your wrist, so you don't, so they don't slip out of your, like your hold, and then you have no control over it. And when you get out to go walk them, you would want to grab them by the base. That's also required. If not, you can get points deducted. And also, when taking them out, if they're small dogs, you would want to do a football hold. Again, it's more control and